as you can probably see, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do very well today. We've been mustering an ever greater number of ferries across the last few days, and we're coming to a climax here on Sunday at the show by having, I believe, 5 ferries about to go onto the water. As I joked earlier on, perhaps it's not a joke, it could be quite serious, this is a branch of the hobby that seems to be gaining momentum. A few years ago, I don't think I ever managed to get a single ferry onto the water. Well, here we are this year, 2018, and we've got 5 of them. And as we move into next year, I expect to see even more modern ferries, because our good friends over at Linkspan Models, one of our trade exhibitors here at the show this year, have been slowly but surely introducing a range of ferries to the market. I'll talk about one of them in a moment, because it's brand new, and it will be available for purchase in the spring of next year. So let's have a look at our ferries. Quite a varied selection here. We have the Finjet. You may know a little bit about the Finjet ferry. It's rather unique and it's powered by gas turbine engines. And then we have the ferry from Cobblefrey Ferries, which is an interesting vessel because it has 2 decks that contains cars, and on the lower and the bottom deck it contains the trailers for the articulated lorries to get those vehicles with all of their weight down into the lower level. This was built by John Wolverance, that lives down near Abingdon in Oxfordshire. And boys and girls sitting around the edge of the pool, when John brings this ferry round, it's called the Celestine. If you look on the top deck, there are nearly 100 scale cars on the top of it. John not only has smoke effects on this model, but it also has a sequence of lighting effects. And as it goes around now, by the magic of radio control, one by one, John will start to activate some of the lights on the vessel. But do have a look at it when it comes around closely, and you'll see all the cars on the upper deck, lights coming on, and you'll notice the loading ramp on the rear of the vessel is now dropping down. And particularly the youngsters around the edge of the pool, as it rotates round, if you look in the back of it, you can see all the lorries within the ferry. You have a big fan here, John. There's a young man that's absolutely enraptured looking at the back of the ferry. And there's a demonstration of using the bow thrusters where the ferry is able to gyrate round and can virtually turn round within its own length. Also on the water, we have 2 variations of the motor vessel, the Norland, one under the flag of North Sea Ferries and the other one under the flag of the P&O shipping line. They are nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, the same vessel, the motor vessel, the Norland, and that is one of the kits which is available from our good friends over there at Linkspan Models. They also offer a kit for the Pride of Hythe, and also, as I said a few moments ago, in the spring of next year, 2019, they will introduce to the market a ferry known as the Spirit of Free Enterprise, and the prototype of that kit is on display on their stand. It's right at the front of the stand, so I do suggest you go and have a look at Linkspan Models. I think these ferries are truly fantastic, and I hope you agree with me. Now, where's he gone? There he is. Our little lad here is pointing at it. He's ahead of the game. He's spotted. We also have a train ferry on the water in its military guise. Well, the young gentleman near the commentary point spotted straight away. Mum, look, there's trains on that boat. This show we particularly have a lot of very knowledgeable and very informed modellers, but for those of you that perhaps don't fit into those categories, you will probably notice by now that some of these ferries not only have lighting effects, they also have smoke effects as well. And across the last few years, as technology moves on, we are putting more and more very clever functionality into the models. And I think when they're on the water with the lights on, it just absolutely brings them to life. It takes it to a new dimension, and with the smoke coming out of the funnels, it really elevates the hobby to a whole new position. I think John's ferry there as it goes around, particularly with all the cars on the deck, with the lights and the smoke, is a truly magnificent sight. One of the things we noticed yesterday, ladies and gentlemen, due to the lighting in the building with these big powerful downlights, when John turns the boat at certain angles, we thought he was pulling a clever trick yesterday, because it looks like the lights have all come on in the cars, and it is in fact the lights in the roof reflecting off them. From where I'm standing at this point, it's not doing it. When he turns it down the other end of the pool, I noticed yesterday it suddenly looks like all the cars light up. I've told him by next year, I want it to throw a switch and light up all 100 headlights. So there's your challenge, John. He's going to be deeply worried now. He's just turned it now. Those people at my end of the pool will see, as he came round and the cars all caught the light, it suddenly looked like they all lit up. For an unplanned effect, John, that is very impressive. So, ferry captains, if I can get you to just cruise for a few moments on the far side of the pool, and then using its bell thruster and the azipod rotating drives under the Voyager of the Seas, we'll get it to move sideways from the harbour. So, ferry captains, if you could just, under your own power, navigate, is probably the right word, to the far side of the pool, and then I'll ask Captain Chilcott, our good friend Paul Chilcott, who built the Voyager of the Seas, just to see if he can move it away from the quayside sideways.